4DVAR stands for four-dimensional variational data simulation.
A numerical weather prediction is an initial state problem. We need to know as accurately as we can the initial state of the atmosphere if we want to have any chance of making accurate predictions.
We first run a short-range forecast, and then we wait until we receive all the observations within an assimilation window. Once we have received all the observations, we go back at the beginning of the time of this window and we adjust the previous forecasts based on all the received observations. So retrospectively, actually, we go back 12 hours and readjust the previous forecast to do an analysis of the last 12 hours. And from that on, then we start running the forecast once we're happy with the result.
4DVAR is the only tool we can use to bring together these observations to build a consistent, physically reasonable state of the atmosphere from which we can launch successful forecasts.
It took almost 10 years from the 80s to the 90s, but we implemented 4DVAR in November 1997. So November 2017 marks the 20 years anniversary of the implementation of 4DVAR at ECMWF. It was very much pushed by the academic community, and in particular the French academic community.
I'd been interested in this question of taking all observations over a period of time, say 12 hours, and combining all this together with a numerical model which computes the evolution of the state of the atmosphere, which showed that this technique could be applied to meteorological problems. And it became four-dimensional variational assimilation, 4DVAR. We went for a meeting at ECMWF. We presented our work, and they were very interested, and they took the decision to develop 4DVAR for their model and for their prediction, to use it for real meteorological prediction.
In the near future, there will be a very large class of new types of observations. They involve radar measurements, LiDAR measurements, even lightning measurements.
These hundreds of millions of observations need to be brought together in a consistent way, and 4DVAR is the only system that can do that. Now, 4DVAR can take information from a satellite, for example, which might be telling us about humidity at maybe 9 o'clock, and it will compare that information with what the satellite tells us at 9:30 or at 10 o'clock and see how that humidity has changed. And it can interpret those changes of humidity not in terms of adding moisture or reducing moisture, but in terms of the wind, which has made that humidity maybe move from one place to another. And so 4DVAR is the only system that can use humidity observations to derive wind information about the atmosphere. And this unique feature is called wind tracing. 4DVAR is being applied into worlds that it was never envisaged to be applied.
In the next 20 years, or at least in the next 10 years, we want to include more components.
So the next thing that has been added to 4DVAR has been an ensemble component, which is used to estimate the uncertainty of that initial estimate that we have. Better knowing the uncertainties improves the actual estimate of the state.
And then we also want to go to higher resolution. So we would like to run an ensemble at 5 kilometers in 10 years' time or so.
4DVAR is, I think, acknowledged the best system in the world, but it will need continuous support. It will need continuous support scientifically from people improving and developing it. It will need support from the member states to provide computing facilities and resources. But whilst that is in place and there's no sign that that's going to go away, then the future is bright with 4DVAR.